saw her standing on her front lawn, just a twirling her baton.
In early February of 1958, my father was appointed to the case, probably within 4 or 5 days after Caril was returned from Wyoming.
From the town of Lincoln, Nebraska, with a sawed off 14 on my leg.
Caril's version was, which Dad accepted, that she was a hostage and that she did not either or see any of her own family killed. They were kept there in the, she was kept there in the house as a hostage, and occasionally, a couple times at least, they went out, but it was always under the threat that if she tried to get away or tried to do anything, her family, whom she believed had been taken hostage by Charlie's gang, as she described it, would be killed.
At least for a little while, sir, me and her, we had some fun.
At that time, there was an overwhelming deference to authority. That if the police charged somebody with something, that was generally, in most people's mind, that meant that they were guilty of it. And I think my father always thought that that was the overwhelming problem, as he described it. It was the inertia, as the word that he used, that people became convinced that she was guilty.
Sheriff, when the man, that sweet sir, and snaps my poor head back, you make sure my pretty baby sitting right there on my lap.
There's a tremendous amount of pretrial publicity, deliberate pretrial publicity generated by the police, county attorney's office, all designed to show that Caril was guilty of this or that. And Dad, who was trying to keep the publicity down, did not allow any interviews with Caril until just before trial. He had the famous allowed NBC, the Today Show, actually, to conduct an interview with Caril. That was because there had been literally months of just innuendo and accusation, interviews in the newspaper, interviewing everybody, all designed to show that she was guilty.
Why do you think he would even implicate you in that if you didn't have anything at all to do with it? Why do you think he'd want to implicate you?
Well, by now I'm sure he hates me for running away. He's trying to make it look like I'm just guilty and foolish.
Had you gone with him for quite a while?
Yes, I'd went with him a year before, and then I told him I didn't want to see him again, but he came back. And after that Sunday, I'd went with him, and then I kept telling him to leave. And at that Sunday, I told him to leave, and I told him I didn't ever want to see him again.
What had brought you to this conclusion? Why didn't you want to go with him anymore?
I think he's crazy.
Well, the emotion in Nebraska was just very extreme. Nothing like this had ever happened in the United States. You didn't have a history, as you do now, of mass murders, history, especially involving children. She was the youngest that had ever been charged with that kind of a thing. And Lincoln, if Lincoln had one murder a year, that was considered about the average.
You want to know why I did what I did? Sir, I guess it's just a meanness in this world.